The behavior and appearance of many animals regularly catches our eye. Researchers like us study such interesting animal behaviors and publish the findings in scientific journals. Here, through each video, we will understand an exciting scientific research which will help us know more about the behavior of animals. In this video, we will look at the importance of tusks in Asian elephants. Males of many species have prominent physical characters. Such characters are definitely not useful in survival, but are useful in producing offspring. How is that so? First, in many species, males have to compete vigorously to win a female partner. Individuals might use these beak structures as weapons to compete with other males. Second, these traits can be used by males to show off its abilities to females who are in search of good genes for their young ones. Males can use these eye-catching physical traits as ornaments to attract a female. If a male wins more battles and gets chosen by more females, he will be a father to more young ones. But understanding if a particular trait is a weapon or an ornament is not always straightforward. Elephant tusks have puzzled researchers for a very long time. Why have elephant tusks evolved? Do they act as weapons and help in winning a male-male battle? Or do they act as ornaments and help in attracting more females? And this is exactly what the researchers have studied here in these two papers. Before going to the studies, let us know a bit more about elephants. Different species of elephants are found in Africa and in Asia. Females of both species live in groups with their young ones. Males, on the other hand, leave such a group when they attain maturity. They stay alone and move around looking for females to mate with. Adult male elephants attain what is called a state of must. Must is a temporary state an elephant is in when it is ready to mate. It can last from a few weeks to a few months. During this time, males show their dominance by displaying a lot, and they show a sharp increase in testosterone hormone. When in must, an oily liquid secreted by the temporal gland runs down a male's cheek. This is one of the ways by which we can identify an elephant in must. In must or not, males compete with other males to show their dominance and to win and guard females. Studies on African elephants have shown that bigger elephants in must are most likely to win competitions and females. But the role of tusks is still unknown. Tusks are the second upper incisor teeth of elephants. Interestingly, all male and female African elephants have tusks. But females of Asian elephants are tuskless or they have really small tusks which are not easily visible. Male Asian elephants can have tusks or can be completely tuskless. In India, in a population, 5 to 90% males can actually be tuskless. Such elephants without tusks are called maknas. So that gets us to our question. What is the function of these odd-looking teeth? To understand this, researchers needed a population with both tusked and tuskless elephants. Exactly such a population with almost 50% tuskless elephants is present in Kaziranga National Park. So the researchers went out to Kaziranga and studied elephants in the dry seasons of 2008 till 2011. Researchers observed elephants from watchtowers or from vehicles. For studying if tusks are used in male-male competition as weapons, researchers video recorded all interactions between males. And for understanding if females find males with tusks more attractive, they video recorded interactions between males and females. In total, they got 468 hours of elephant video recordings. But statistical analysis cannot be conducted on behavior data in the form of videos because analysis needs numbers. The observers then watched each video multiple times and converted these observations to numbers. This is a very crucial and time-consuming step since it is approximative that we need 3 times the duration of a video to convert the data video to a data sheet. Once the data sheet was in place, it was ready to be analyzed. So first, are tusks used in male-male fights? observers recorded 131 competitive interactions. Such interactions included an elephant male just approaching another male. It included elephants having physical contact, elephants chasing each other, or even engaging in aggressive fights like this one. Out of these, a clear winner and a loser was observed in 116 interactions. Observers identified the winner, the loser, and noted the musk status, tusk status, and difference in body size of both competing males for every interaction. If tusks give an advantage in winning a battle, males with tusks should always win a battle, irrespective of its body size and musk status. Analysis showed that when two elephants were competing, males with musk were almost always the winners in the fight. If both players had equal musk, the one with a bigger body size was the winner. And only if the elephants had equal musk and equal body size was having tusks an advantage. But this was only seen in around 12% of interactions. In addition, aggressive physical fights, including a tusked male, were observed only 19 times by observers. This is because males in musk or bigger males were hardly ever challenged for a fight by a weaker opponent. Plus, if there was a physical fight, unlike the African elephants, tusks were not used in aggressive interactions. Instead, males were seen headbutting and wrestling with head and trunks. To add to this, the tusks of Asian elephants are very fragile and can easily break if used in a fight. In fact, it is even weaker than bamboo. When a weapon is so delicate, it is typically not fit to be used as a weapon. In short, males with stronger musk and bigger size had a much greater advantage than having tusks. Elephant tusks are unlikely to provide a substantial advantage in male-male fight and hence unlikely to be used as weapons. So do females prefer males with tusks over tuskless males? For understanding this, researchers recorded females in the presence of males. For every interaction, researchers noted down the musk status, tusk status, and estimated body size of the male. They also noted if a female actively showed interest in a male and the time she spent with a particular male. If tusks are ornaments, females should be more responsive and spend more time with tusked males, irrespective of its size and musk. But analysis showed that again, females did not prefer tusked males over non-tusked males. Instead, she showed a positive response to bigger males in musk. So being in musk and being bigger in size were again important, and tusks are unlikely to be used as ornaments. So to conclude, in Asian elephants, data suggests that tusks do not seem to be used as weapons or as ornaments. Then why are the tusks even there? Researchers suggest that tusks may have evolved before musk. So tusks might have been used in winning a battle or in acquiring mates before musk evolved. But in due course, body size and musk might have shown some other advantage over tusks and hence grew stronger across generations. Interestingly, researchers also suggest that because tusked males do not seem to have a strong advantage over tuskless males, and because tusked males are getting poached for ivory, evolution can favor tuskless males. So tusked males can actually go extinct from a population in which elephants are poached for ivory, and all males will eventually be tuskless. I'm sure looking at elephants and their tusks is never going to be the same for most of us now. If you learned something new today, do like this video and share it to spread information. If you have any questions or want to discuss animal behavior, write to me at ecol.devika@gmail.com. Hope to come back soon with another ecology research explained.